Right or wrong? So imagine now an Avi would come to us and say, I want to save you from the Arabs. You want to get rid of all the Arabs that are torturing you nonstop? I need you 4 days of bravery. That's the right word, bravery? 4 days of bravery. You go to all the mosques in Israel, cut that moon that they have with the picture of Muhammad, put everything in the middle of Tel Aviv and make a big fire. What would happen in Israel when the Arabs would see the first thing you cut? What would happen in Israel? Intifada multiplied by 100. Disaster. You're not going to be able to get out of your house. So if the rabbi would come and say to the Jews, now it's your opportunity to get rid of all the Ishmaelim. They won't bother you after that. This is what you have to do for 4 days. Do you think anyone would come to do it? Besides some fanatic religious people that would say, Shema Israel, I'm going to die for Hashem. How many? 50? I'll be surprised if there will be 50. Most people won't have the guts. Won't have the guts. This is actually what Hashem said to the Jews. Take their God, tie it to the bed, that they will ask you, what are you going to do with my God? So I'm going to cut him to pieces. In your country, in your face, and there's nothing you're going to do about it, because you are nothing. My God controls the world, not your God. Your God is nothing. Soon it's going to be in my stomach and in the bathroom. This is what you have to tell them. Do you know what a test it is? And therefore, Hashem said to Moshe, if they're going to pass these two tests, meaning they're willing to suffer for me, to cut pieces in the body, and if they're willing to die for me, they deserve the Torah. If not, they don't deserve it. Mamash amazing. That's why Hashem chose these two mitzvot. One is suffering all the way, one is I'm willing to die all the way. And they did it. And this is what we send Brit Milah. Va'omar lach bedamai chayi, the blood of Brit Milah, and the blood of the Korban HaPesach.